the bands, what you cooking?
I could tell you that I'm proud of myself. I grew up hard, but that's just the way it is, baby boy. All the neighbors, they ain't want me with the kids. Probably thought that I'd die, but now you see the way I live on. I done made crops feel that's just
that role of a father being there for the daughter and also for the son.
Best decisions I made, progress as I'm going along, as you can see yourself. But
I think you do put God in a box. I think people try to put something that's way more than
smoking the shit between. I was stressing over you while you wildin' out with your friends. With my brother in the coupe, go to pop and we shootin' again, yeah. And I came out to see.
And I think we had the Pearl Yard downtown. That are definitely more family than family. Thicker than blood, man, to be honest with you, bro. You know what I mean?
Shutting us real bad, we she gon' ride me around. I tell her for the stop at the light. Get off the ground, not making friends, and she fuck with it. She made a video, I would them, and I'm loving it. I got a group of baby women want
to talk. Ain't seen shit, bro.
They won't see me winning. I was in the prison, missing my children. Oh, I come from playing with that glizzy. Trying to hit them, caught a fist. I ain't rapping, I ain't taking me. Stuck up in, I feel like I'm home. I still feel like I'm home. And that's the smallest thing that's been going wrong. Feel like my mom been going away for like way too long.
What's up, YouTube? It's Big Merle. I'm sitting here with one of my best friends, like a brother to me, James Warner. This is our first podcast. I told y'all about this earlier that we're going to start this. This is my first trip up here, and it's going to be our first sit down with many more to come. James is actually in the process of starting his own YouTube channel, y'all. We haven't got that fully functioning rolling yet, but it's in the making. So look forward to start seeing him soon and start seeing him, me and him networking here pretty soon, and a lot more to come. Okay, so first question, James, how do you feel about God versus religion?
Faith and religion, I think faith. Religion is something that you go through every day on a day to day, and like it's like a ritual, whereas like faith, you know, in God, naturally, it's just something that's more spiritual that you feel on the inside.
Okay, so thank you for that, James. So with that being said, how do you feel about Christian versus Baptist versus Muslim or somebody that just...
Okay, that's a good question. I think in the end, as long as you believe in God, I think that's what really matters. I don't think that, and I mean, when you look at it like this, how come Muslims and Jews and Christianity are all connected to the same thing? I don't think that we should fight each other or be against each other in any form. We should be united on the same front, if anything. All right, so Merle, I'm gonna ask you a question. What's your standpoint on the same question that you just asked me?
My standpoint is, for me, just speaking on my faith and my walk with God, I feel like nothing against Christians, Muslim, or whatever your choice of religion is, but I feel like you put God in a box when you do that. And me, I'm not going to put him in a box. God said he can do all things. So I'm a believer in God, and I walk by faith, not by sight. But I don't stick to a certain religion. Don't get me wrong, religious people, who, whatever you follow, but that's just something that's not for.
I think you're right. I think you do put God in a box. I think people do. I think people try to put people in life as a whole, like in boxes, and you tend to, how do I say, make less of something that's way more than it actually is.
It's meant to be great.
Right.
Exactly. That's a blessing that you say that, because Sarah Jakes just had a sermon about people in their systems, and that's part of that system. People like to pull you in their system, which is a box.
Right.
You know what I mean? And once you get caught up in that system, you don't see outside of it. You may see outside of it, but you don't feel like you can get out of it. But once you see out of it and you choose to move outward, they don't like it because we mess up the flow of their system, because it's an ecosystem. back to the system. People with their system, because it's the ecosystem, is what Sarah Jakes was explaining. So if I step outside of the system, I'll take your system off balance because you need me in certain aspects of certain areas that I'm no longer willing to be a part of anymore.
Right. Well, when you say ecosystem, you're talking about a whole system of being. So like the air you breathe, the water that you drink. So yeah, you become a hook on all of that, you know, as a whole.
Elaborate on how your journey has been from being a single man to being a father.
Going from being single to like having kids, that's a big difference, man. Before I only had to take care of myself, so it really didn't matter, you know what I mean? I knew I was gonna always be okay if I had to sleep in the streets or whatever, but for my kids, it's not an option. So I have to, you know, failure's not an option, bro. So it's like, you have to go all the way. You know what I mean? I think that's like what's lacking today in society, especially with men. And I mean, a lot of times we can get real confused as men versus women, but in a men's role, like, we need to try to be there for our children and even maybe other children like around us that we see, so that they know what a man is, and you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think we had that missing in our lives, and it's just getting worse, and it's not gonna make anything better that way. I think it's important for boys and girls to get that role of a father being there for the daughter. She's learning the how a man's supposed to treat her, and what, you know, the expectation that she has to be good to her man. And then also for the son, it's teaching him the position of a man and how he's supposed to treat the woman. I think overall that the family is the, like the single most important thing in society. Like, we're lacking a lot of that today, and that's what's driving us apart and making us, if you look at all of the ugly things in society, society's broken on a lot of levels right now. And I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that it's a lack of family and family structure as a whole. I don't know.
It's very true, because I remember growing up, how things were when we were growing up. It was always family reunions, family meetings. Everybody would always go to grandma's house or uncle's house. You really don't see that no more. You really don't see family reunions and people sticking together as they used to back when I was young. Now, it's like everybody's divided. Everybody's doing their own thing. Everybody's on social media, and that's how they're keeping in touch instead of actually physically being present and seeing and feeling that love from one another.
I agree. I think everything's went more digital and less analog, that physical touch and talk and expression and connection that we used to have when we were younger. I mean, that's where we have to, as the man or the woman in the house, to say, you know, you got to turn that TV off, or turn that tablet off, turn off that console or the computer, and sit down and let's participate.
Second part of the video, we just got there.
Let's go in here and see what's going on, guys. It looks like they got some news.
Showing me that
new problem, man.
It really is.